Now me getting mad at K-drama, lol, okay. Yo, K-drama breakup for so.
Shut the f*** up, bitch.
Hello everyone, hope you're doing well. And as some of you may know, the last two episodes of Dodo So So La La Soul just aired this past Wednesday and Thursday as I'm recording this, so November 25th and 26th. And I don't really know how to put how I feel about the ending besides what the f- what happened to this ending? I don't want to go into too much detail just yet. I do have some opinions, some strong feelings about how they decided to end this drama. But I thought I wanted to change it up a bit, you know, relax. And this is something that I do off camera all the time anyway. I'm going to go and look up online what others are thinking and feeling about the ending to Dodo So So La La Soul. And kind of react, comment on it, share how I'm feeling, but I thought that would be a little more entertaining than hearing me just rant fully for 30 minutes. But that might still be the case very shortly. I'm already heated about it. Let's get into reacting and commenting to things on the internet about the ending to Dodo So So La La Soul. So here's the review. Everything we've seen in the weeks has really been leading up to this, especially with June hinting that he could potentially pass away, yet I, like many others, I assume, didn't see this coming, and it was definitely quite emotional. Yeah, I bawled my eyes out. I cried so hard, and then to have what happened in the end happen, like, my emotions, I'm hurt. Like, my heart hurts from crying so hard, and then for no reason. However, after the absolute roller coaster ride of emotion, we do get a happy ending for all involved as June returns. It's a little fairy tale-esque, and the sudden return perhaps undoes some of the emotional weight the reveal about June's death actually had earlier on. This is, however, a theory going around that the June we saw at the end isn't actually the real one, but an apparition summoned by the music. It is admittedly quite abrupt the way he suddenly pops back up. Yeah. I'd say so. And I can understand why some people would be torn over this one. So what do you think of that ending? Is June really alive, or is this all in Ra Ra's mind? Yeah, that was something that I kind of was thinking about as well. Like, is Ra Ra just having a flashback? Like, she is just sort of going to visit him and see him whenever she plays, you know? Like, he's always with her through the music, that sort of symbolism. But it didn't seem that way. It didn't seem that way at all, you know? Because if that were the case, I feel like there would have been a different sort of scene, not him running up being like, I'm back, surprise, but more him just sort of appearing beside her on the piano and just, you know, watching her play, and then her sort of looking at him, and then something to the effect with a voiceover of like, you know, you'll always be with me through the music, or something to that nature. That would have been a little more poetic than him seemingly coming back from the dead. As a healing drama and a rom-com to boot, this one definitely hits all the right notes, though. It's not perfect, but definitely has some very memorable moments throughout. When it comes to Korean dramas in 2020, Dodo So So La La Soul is definitely up there with one of the best, and it's most certainly had a lot of dramatic and funny moments along the way. So I was thinking that same thing until this ending, because this ending is just so confusing. So I love the title. Spoiler alert, the ending of Lee Jae-wook's Dodo So So La La Soul that had fans asking, what the f*** is going on? Yeah. So we're going to go to Reddit. My favorite place for finding the drama. So this is on Reddit. This is on the subreddit K-drama. If you're not familiar with it and you like K-drama, definitely check it out, because I'm on this constantly. Oh my God, guys, I just realized something. In the past 5 years, did no one attempt to visit June's grave or go to his funeral? And did June not use his social media in the past 5 years? How is he even able to prevent everyone from knowing that he's still alive? Yeah. Yeah, I didn't even think about that. What the f*** did I just watch? When Jim's mom said he died, I literally bawled my eyes out and kept crying for the remainder of the show. Same. And in the last 2 minutes, he suddenly pops out of nowhere and says he's alive? I am traumatized. I am traumatized too. I don't know. I don't know. Bagnet, bagnet, bagnet. My thoughts exactly. I was crying throughout most of the episode when I just went, what the fuck, over and over again, what the show, after the show ended. I need an explanation for the fake out. I thought June was going to explain himself to Ra Ra, or that there was going to be an epilogue with a little montage, but the show just ended. Seriously, what the fuck? This has been one of my favorite dramas, but I don't know if I can rewatch it with this ending. I am feeling the same way about that. I even suggested this drama as one to watch in another video I posted. And it's one of those things that maybe some, now that it's out and people can kind of get spoiled and know to expect that, they can sort of appreciate it more and like, oh, that's kind of funny that they just ruined the ending. But I don't know. I kind of agree with that. I don't think I can actually recommend this drama anymore. KB drama, 2 minutes of happy ending after the big mess is not okay. Like, instead, crying tears of sadness, I am crying tears of betrayal madness. Ugh! Should I give up on K-dramas? No! Do not give up on K-dramas. This is just part of it. This is part of watching K-dramas, is sometimes the writers and directors, something goes awry, and suddenly the ending is weird. I've watched a few dramas that the ending is just like, what just went on? I mean, take a look at the Netflix series Vagabond, how that one ended. Now, there were rumors that there was supposed to be season two, and that's why they sort of ended it in that weird, like, what's gonna happen ending, but I don't see that happening. There's no real actual ending. That's one example. There's another one that I just can't think of the drama's name right now, where it seemed like this couple was going to have this amazing happy ending, and then they just end up getting killed and they die holding each other's arms. But it was like not necessary. It was not necessary. And I am one to appreciate a romantic death, you know, I'm fine with that, but this was not needed. Jay Midori, I think, is gonna have a point here, and this is true. I've thought about this as well. His mom never said he died. That was implied. What I understood is that he was in such condition, maybe like a coma, and she thought there was no hope. So before that happened, I think June told his mom to tell Ra Ra that she shouldn't wait for him anymore, and she should live her life, and probably said the same to everyone else. June said he was in the US, so it's not like they can go visit him at any time they want, and the mom probably told them not to go because June didn't want them to see him like that. So maybe June's mom thought he was going to die and preparing everything. But then he got better and was able to come back and didn't have time to tell anyone because he wanted to see Ra Ra so bad, and that he just came back to be with her. Okay, I mean, the mom came dressed in black, okay? All the signs were there. Like, why would she give everyone goodbye notes? Also, the worst part of that, so when they're having that little 5 year later group lunch, dinner thing that they're all having, it's a celebration, I believe, they mention how Mr. Kim is no longer with them either, how June died and then Mr. Kim died. Well, Mr. Kim died thinking, believing that June died. And also, does Joan ever find out that Mr. Kim passed away? It's just all so unbelievable. I mean, why would the mother come dressed in black? If he was in a coma, they should have shown that he was in a coma. You know, like, they shouldn't expect us to speculate like this. Like, they were very good at sort of explaining things up until this point. Let's finish it off strong, guys. Let's do that. NinDS, I feel this. I'm so upset with how this was handled. You're telling me he left his friend, family, and Eunpo mourn and grieve for 5 years. Yeah, so he pretty much was like, tell them I'm dead. I'm not gonna feel sad that they're crying over me for 5 years. Like, they're never gonna be the same. And then you're just gonna pop back in and think that everything's okay. And that's how they made it seem. It was only for 1 to 2 minutes, then he popped out like nothing happened. I was so mad relieved, I nearly killed him in a homicidal rage. That was 20 years ago and still remains the thing we never mention. I can't imagine if he left me to think that he was dead for five f***ing years. Rara forgave him like nothing, sending his mother to tell her he died, and she didn't say, "Hey son, that's a terrible idea. Remember how it felt when your friend died?" What the hell happened to this happy fluffy drama? The last few episodes jumped the shark. Yeah, it really did. And that's a really good point. Yeah, June's best friend died on him for real. Why would he put somebody through that when he knows what it feels like? That's a really good point. And there's people that like really actually like the ending. I'm seeing them and I wanna, good for them. I think that's really great. I'm not one of those people. I really think that one comment I came across where it was like maybe the director and the writer just had a different idea for the ending and so they just put both endings in the end. Like that honestly feels like the most plausible one. And they were like, we'll just see who liked which ending best. I don't know. Okay, those were good. Let's try TikTok.
Been thinking really long.
And do. All right. Oh my god. Now me getting mad at K-drama, lol. Okay. Yo, K-drama breakup for so.
Shut the fuck up, bitch.
Okay, well, I think we've seen enough. I obviously am not the only one feeling the way I am feeling about the ending to Dodo So So La La Soul. Let me know in the comments down below what you thought of the ending. It's okay if you like the ending. It's okay to be happy that the characters got to be together, whether it's all in her mind or he really just faked his death for 5 years just so that she didn't feel bad that her boyfriend could be dying. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did, please make sure to give this video a like and make sure to share this video with any of your friends that also love K-dramas. I'm sure they're feeling a little devastated right now if they're watching that show. And until next time, thank you so much for watching and I'll see you soon. Bye. Kimchi bimbap. Kimchi bimbap. Kimchi bibibop. Bim bim bop. Oh my god.